Nathan Oakley, and this is going to be a Dawn appeal to all flat earth users.
Also, Australia, which we have in this shape, is not in this shape at all. Because somebody in Perth is looking at the sun and they're saying, hold on, the sun is much too far south.
Hawaii is shown as further east than it really is.
This is it. I'm thinking that Hawaii and New Zealand are around the same longitudinal line.
Yes, yes.
We are told that the time is this over there. But we know.
So this is the timetable for tracking the sun on a flat earth. As you can see from the left-hand side column, we will be running the actual hangout in GMT or GMT.
This will be a quick tutorial on how to share the sunrise or sunset from your location.
July the 3rd, 2016, and then you are in the core. It is pretty much as simple as that. So that's basically all you need to do in order to join the tracking the sun over a flat
earth. Hi, I'm Nathan Oakley, and this is a tracking the sun on a flat earth update. Hope to see you all in about 24 hours' time for the first ever tracking the sun on a flat earth experiment. I've been Nathan Oakley, see you in the next video.
Good evening, and welcome to Tracking the Sun on a Flat Earth Live. This is the first, or hash one, in a series of many hangouts which will be running around the clock. Now, I have actually started a little bit early because very shortly we will have Arlene from Guam joining us with her sunset. She's just figuring out how to get her camera phone nice and steady. So in the meantime, I'm going to present my sunset here in Warwickshire, UK, for you to all see, which I'll present with you, so that at the very least we can start on a bit of a high with two sunsets that are vast distances apart. So this hangout will run with a little bit of dead air just while we wait for Arlene to join, and we will take it off from there. So the time here in Warwickshire is 9:15 or 21:15 BST, which is GMT plus one, and you can probably see the sun. It has actually technically gone down because it's well behind the trees, but yeah, you can still obviously see that the sun is still there, so we will leave that running in the meantime.
New Zealand, New Plymouth.
Superb. What sort of time is it there, Westy?
Just gone 8 o'clock.
AM?
AM.
So you've got your sun coming up then. Marvellous. Can we see?
It's a bloody clear day today, mate.
It doesn't matter.
East.
Doesn't matter who looks like.
Is it showing?
Perfect.
This is it. It's looking directly east.
Directly east. Super. Is there any way you can position that to stay exactly like that?
Oh, I can do this. Yep. How long? 10 minutes?
Yeah, about that. Just so we've got your the fact that you've got sun, and then should somebody else join from a different location, it means that obviously they may have sun at a time that they shouldn't if you have it. Does that make sense?
Yep.
So the only way we're going to achieve that is by having, like, you've got there and like I've got here, you know, people showing where their sun is. Oh, there we go. How you doing, buddy? Whereabouts are you?
Hi. Trying to sort it out.
Can you point your camera towards your sun, buddy? Wherever
yes,
that may be.
Unfortunately, it's just gone down.
That doesn't matter.
What is the direction of... Oh, no. Am I still here?
It doesn't matter. So long as we can see it, just all we need, pretty though you are, is that you've just shown us. So however long you stay on, that's what you need to show us the entire time. Whereabouts are you?
We're in Worksop, near Sheffield.
Worksop. Well, that's good, because we've got now two locations. So we've got Warwickshire, UK, and Worksop.
Daytime, meaning it's about 6:30 in the morning, Sunday morning.
So yeah, but that's a blue sky with the sun, wouldn't you agree?
Yep,
the sun is there somewhere. So sorry, what's the exact time?
About 6:30 Sunday morning.
6:30 in the morning, wow, very early. What is your location?
I'm now in Murmansk, Russian Federation.
And what's your local time?
It is now 11 45 and p.m. and I'm driving to the highest point in Murmansk just to show you the sun's position.
And you're in Sheffield, aren't you, George?
Yes, works up closer to Nottingham.
I still haven't managed to get my other device to connect. I might give it one last go on the original one, the iPad, so excuse me for a second, guys.
George?
Hi.
Hi. Is that a sunrise or a sunset?
That's a sunset. It's GMT London time, so... and you're facing northeast, exactly northeast.
Yeah, and I pulled off, pulled over, and now I, my car is almost north direction. Sure. I can show you.
Thanks. Great though that is.
Almost north direction is my car to GPS.
Yeah, we still haven't got your...
Like that.
That's it. If you can just keep your camera there, because it's spectacular, mate, and that's what we need. Don't worry about your direction and stuff. You can give us that later. But for the now, if you can just get your camera so that it's positioned permanently like that, that'd be brilliant.
Yeah, I'll try to keep this.
So can you tell us where you are?
I'm in Murmansk. Russian Federation, above the Arctic Circle, close to Norway.
So you're North Norway, and it's midnight.
Yeah, it's, yeah, how much is time now? Local time, 24:00.
0:00, so yeah, midnight.
Midnight, yes.
Super. Let's have a quick check back on Scotland.
It's nearly 8 a.m. Well, is it 8 a.m. yet? Yeah. You see it?
Yeah. Can you position it in such
Sorry,
a way
man,
that you can keep it pointing at the sun? Is that a possibility?
What? That?
Can you position your camera so it's permanently pointing at the sun? I'm just conscious that you've got to hold it constantly and we'll just get wavy camera looking at your blinds like we are. Hey, that's pretty ace. There you go.
Sorry, man, this is my first go at this.
No, make no apologies. You're doing really well. That's excellent. So is this now pointing pretty much at the sun?
It's pointing west. I live at Castle Hill in Sydney, just above the Castle Hill Library. So you can find me exactly. And I'm looking west, out towards Blue Mountains. Got a pretty good view.
You're currently muted.
Okay, can you hear me now?
I can hear you now. Can you?
Okay.
You've got blinds behind you, and it looks like the sun coming through them, my friend. Can you at least point your camera at the sun for us?
I can do that. It's not anywhere near sunset yet.
Doesn't matter. Okay.
I'm gonna go in the front. This is Southern California. We're at about 1,000 feet elevation. And let's see here. I think I can only go about 20 feet from the house.
Perfect. Oh, mate, that's brilliant. Can you tilt your camera just a little bit higher? Oh, that's superb.
You see that?
Yeah, that's excellent. So what time of day is it?
What time of day here?
Yes.
45 p.m.
Can you repeat that, please?
So it's... It's past noon, so it's I would say about maybe 10 or 15 degrees past high noon.
And is it 10 to midday there? Is it 11:50? What time is it?
No, it's 3:45 p.m.
Welcome to number two, Tracking the Sun on a Flat Earth Live on Nathan Oakley 1980s channel. It's Patricia Steer, and if you've got a sunrise or sunset to share, please do so.
Now, this is quite good, actually, Patricia, because it means at 12:30, unless somebody else presses the red telephone, should I put that in, or should I just tell the hosts individually that don't press the red telephone, like Robin something. Has done and Robert has now done?
If you push the red button. Hello, Paul Kofu. How are you?
Good,
well
thanks.
Done.
I'm doing very good, thanks.
So just before I do, we'll get back to where I was on the last hangout, if you will, Patricia. Can you click on Paul and just see if you present him to everybody?
Like, all right.
Put the white box around him, so to speak.
There he is, presenting to everyone. Wow, the way the sun looks, the exterior part of the sun, the, I don't know what you call that, rays, I guess? Pretty amazing looking. Looks like an explosion.
It's we've had a couple of really, really clear, crisp days. I mean, the temperature is quite cool. It's quite cold, but the atmosphere is clear. It's about as crisp as it's been for a long time. So
where are you exactly?
Tauranga, New Zealand.
Say the name of the town again.
Tauranga. Tauranga.
I've never heard of it. Interesting.
Yeah, it's a little, the place I'm actually in is Mount Maunganui, at 38 degrees south.
Mm. So what we're seeing on camera is probably quite different from what you'd see in person, just because it looks like no sun I've ever seen before, because there's a flare around it. But I guess that's what happens with the camera. So
I should imagine that's probably just a peculiarity with the lens. So I'm filming what you're seeing this filmed on at the moment. It's just my MacBook, the camera on the MacBook. So
are you Kofo?
Yes.
Yes, Antonio. I'm Kofo. Yeah.
Nice to meet you, man. How are you doing?
Yeah, very good. Thanks, Antonio. Very good.
Cool.
Good.
Hello,
gorgeous
people. Where are you?
Can you hear me now?
Yes, I can hear you.
Okay. St. George, Utah.
Ah.
It's about 102. Is everybody...
Oh, we hear somebody trying to connect Skype. Or semi-bad connection, but we do see your son.
Oh, I good. Hear you. I've got two fucking copies of this going right now.
All right.
Mason. There we go.
Wait, put it back up again. Oh, you got it. Good.
I just said, Mason, turn your mic on.
This is good. Stand by to write more notes.
Digital.
Mason, are you there? Mason? No, Mason is not there. Robo, hold your sign up one more time. We're closer to the camera. Lift it up higher. I can see he's doing something. Mason, you got it? You there? Hello? The thumb is up. You have to speak. Mason, hello. Testing. 1, 2, 3. Mason, come in. I keep saying the word Mason.
He has a good smile. That's good enough, right?
He has a lovely smile. And a hoodie. I'm all in favor of hoodies, as some may know.
Westy's here, mate.
Hi, Westy.
How are you?
Looking beautiful, that, what you got there. Is it where you live?
That's in New Plymouth, New Zealand.
Yes. It's gorgeous.
And it's 11:40 a.m. And that's pretty much north-northeast.
Mm. How are you?
I'm good. How are you? Fantastic. You guys are awesome. I love you guys.
You're awesome for doing this. Where are you and what are we seeing?
I'm in Plymouth, Massachusetts, and I'm going to do the sunrise at 5 a.m. too,
oh,
over
good.
The water.
Ooh, that'll be perfect.
I hope so.
Yeah. Massachusetts is a beautiful place. Been there.
So what are we seeing now?
This is the sunset, but it really isn't going to set for another half an hour. I just wanted to test out to see. So that's the sun, obviously.
Yeah.
going down.
The sunsets are just as important as the sunrise.
Allison, do you know what your elevation is?
Pretty close to sea level. Pretty close to sea level.
Okay. Well, one of the reasons we want people to give their location is that we can verify elevations later, because some people might not be familiar with programs that show elevation and whatnot. So that's part of the reason that we want to hear their location.
Well, thank you guys. I appreciate getting to talk to you. Thanks.
Thank you, Allison. See you tomorrow in the morning for your sunrise. Bye. So
With
the sun, how does it change the size if it's 90 million miles away? Earth's only, 8,000 miles across, so you're only going to see 4,000 miles difference, and it changes size so much.
Yes, so this is one of the things that the globalists like to say does not happen. They say it never changes sizes. So when you show them videos of it actually changing size, like Buckhead's word, they say, nope, I'm going to look at this video where it doesn't change size.
And the moon. The moon's 240,000 miles away, and you can see into the craters.
Yeah.
That's just... Well,
and I don't know who this is, but we're going to put him up there so we can all see the cat. It's Kathy. And we've also got Phil joining us while Kathy turns the camera on. Hey, Phil, where are you calling from? I guess you're not calling, but...
Well, it's still a call. How are you, Patricia?
It is. Hi, how are you?
Good, thanks. I'm in, there you go, over my shoulder, Perth, Western Australia.
That is so beautiful, the way the sun is coming through the pines.
You've got our sunset. One of the first to see it today.
So beautiful.
I know, I picked a spot specially for that.
It's maybe the best picture I've seen thus far. They're all beautiful, but you've got it all going on there.
It's not too bad.
Not too bad.
So I had to wait a little bit. Sun rises a little earlier today, but because it's rising over the land, we're in the western end. We need a little bit more time. So there you go.
So Patricia, I just wanted to say something.
Yes, Allison.
So he's in Australia and he's seeing the sun rising while I'm in Massachusetts and still seeing the sun setting. So that's kind of interesting to note. That
there's
I can still see the sun and he sees it in Australia.
Right. And this is, I don't know the science of this that they would tell us. But they would probably tell us that doesn't happen.
I'll have to look at their official map or whatever, but it just kind of interesting that I wouldn't think in Australia we could see the sun at the same time, but I'll have to look into that.
Well, we've got Phil here, and you said you might do some screen share and time and date.
I couldn't work it out.
Oh, no, okay.
One comment on that, though, is, and we don't have Antonio's Gleason's map behind him right at the moment, but 6 a.m. here... in Perth, on the Gleason map, if you move that around 90 degrees, then that should be 12 midnight. And further 90 degrees would be 6 p.m. on the other side of the world. So I think it should be quite plausible, I would have thought. But of course, the sun's circulating closer into the center, so you'll see it longer up your way.
We've got Antonio back, so probably to show us the map.
Well, he heard his name, did he?
I think he might have. Yes, Phil was just talking about the Gleason's map and was talking about you and the Gleason's map and what you could say about where the sun would be.
Where it would be now?
Yes, where would it be positioned right now on the Gleason's projection?
So it's setting where you are.
It's rising in Perth, so it would be perhaps around New Zealand, but it's got to be around the Tropic of Cancer somewhere.
Yeah, so...
I am
somewhere
in
there?
I'm trying to work it out. So... you're in New Zealand. Is it just rising or just setting?
I'm in Perth, Western Australia. Yep.
And so you're in Perth here?
Yes.
Yeah. And it's just rising where you are?
Just rising. Probably sunrise was an hour ago, but it's just because it's rising over the land, it's taking a little bit of time to show itself.
So it will be around here. It should be around here.
And you've got your finger on the Tropic of Cancer there?
Yes.
Yeah.
And it has not set in Seattle yet. So it looks like we still have some time to go before we're this distance away from Seattle.
Speaking of Seattle, Robin Poe has joined us with her globe. We should all play a laugh track every time that globe is shown, but we don't have one. So
well, we have to book it word.
Yes. And we've already spoke with Nick. He's unable to actually speak, but and we've got you, Kathy. Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm very good. How are you, Patricia?
I'm good. Where are you, and what do we see here?
I am in Midland, Michigan, and I'm actually surprised at how high it still is. It's probably going to be up for another hour, but I wanted to make sure to get it in.
Now, I lived in Kalamazoo, Michigan when I was a teenager, and it seems like it should be darker than that.
It'll stay light after the sun goes down till about 10:30.
Mm-hmm.
So it'll be twilight.
What time do you have now?
It is 8:05.
Okay.
So it's probably going to go down about 9, because there's trees behind me.
Midland, Michigan. Kathy, yes. Thank you for coming on and sharing your sun. Hello, Michigan.
Yes, you weren't too far from me, actually, where you used to live.
Yeah, Kalamazoo's not too far.
No.
The people put their hand up like a mitten, and then they say
That's
where
right.
they live.
Right.
And I kind of lived in Western Michigan University is where it is.
Right.
The Kalamazoo, Michigan location.
West side of the state.
Exactly. West side.
Well, good luck to you in your new future endeavors.
Aw, thank you, Kathy. Thanks for coming on. All
okay,
right.
Okay, no problem.
Bye.
Bye.
That was nice of her.
So, is this the sun rising from where you are? Setting?
We have midnight sun here.
Ah, okay. So, what time is it now on your watch?
2 o'clock in the night.
Wow.
That's
awesome.
Amazing. I've never seen anything like that with my own eyes. So.
No, the sun stays up all 24/7 here now.
So,
really?
Gaze, what direction is it? What compass direction?
North is there.
North?
Right to the sun is north.
Directly north.
Let's look on the Gleason's map.
Yeah. So directly north brings it here.
And in Norway, do you know Norway?
Yes, here. I'm showing it with my finger on the Gleason's map.
Yes, top of the Norway, and north I see the sun.
Yeah, so straight across. So about here.
Yeah, maybe there, yes.
Yeah, on the Tropic of Cancer. So the thing that's making me a big question mark is New Zealand, which is there. How long ago did it rise in New Zealand? Does anybody remember when Kofo said? What was it? 3 hours ago?
I wish he,
we'll see on the recording.
Remember. Right, exactly.
Okay. Nesebi. Okay.
Yes. Nesebi.
Brilliant.
Sounds like you're saying NASA. No, you're not.
That is awesome because that helps us to study how far the light reaches.
Yeah.
Also, 1 hour ahead of UK, you are more east than UK. Yes.
North of UK.
Yes, but also east. North, so the south.
Yes. We have. We are very long east.
Yes. And here in the latitude, we can find that Spain is in the wrong place in the Gleasons, because they are also 1 hour ahead of UK.
We have someone just joining us. I will say Gaylord, because I can't pronounce your name. Thank you so much. I may come back to you unless you leave, but we have Russell and Friend who has joined us. Hello there, young one.
But just to say, I can come on later on.
Oh, please, yes, that would be wonderful.
So I talked to Nathan too in 12 o'clock. So now it's 2, so maybe 4 I can come on again.
Fantastic.
Then the sun will be almost there. Some.
Hi, can you hear me?
Oh, I can hear you. Hello.
Hey, hi. Great. I'm just I'm trying to get this.
Good. Lift your camera up, because right now we're just seeing the railing of your. Ooh,
oh,
right.
Okay.
Oh, right. There we go.
Yeah, aha. So. East, northeast.
Yeah.
It's here. For you.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Okay. Yes, it confirms with New Zealand, Perth, and the US. Hey, Nick, how you doing, man?
I'm good. Great to talk to you, finally.
Yeah, I've been watching your videos, and I've been telling everybody, like, people that are, you know, that have obviously watched your videos before, to go back and look at what you've been doing. Because some of the stuff you've been doing is absolutely stunning.
Yes.
I've been telling everybody to look at when you're describing the coins and how Newton ascribed value.
Okay.
That, yeah. I think that's very, very important for people to understand.
Okay, yeah, great. It's just, I'm glad that's taken off, and thank you for sharing that, because it was something that was kind of, you know, once you research, you do a bit of research, it kind of becomes quite clear that's what happened.
Yes.
So, yeah, great. Yeah.
Yes, of course. So, thank you for the videos. I've been loving them.
Yes. My comments. The channel is Phuket Word. It's Nick Davies, and it's about 7:17 a.m. as the sun is coming up there for him.
Yes. I'm just hoping to see if there are any sunspots, and obviously if anyone's got the ability to zoom in and see for themselves where sunspots are, I think that's a really good way of seeing from what angle we're actually all looking at the sun. So if, for example, I can see sunspots on the bottom, and someone else can see those same sunspots on a different location, then that will give us a really clear idea of the angles we're looking at the sun at.
Yes.
Thanks a lot for letting me be a part of it. It's great to be doing this, and I think we're going to learn something for sure.
Mm-hmm. Yes, we are.
Mm.
Yeah. Mm.
Where are you in reality? You're in the mountains? I can't really hear you that well, sorry. Matthew Meekes, who's here. Where are you again?
In North Carolina. Someone's got feedback on their mic.
I don't hear anything.
Yes. I heard it. Carolina. South Carolina.
I'm in Boone, North Carolina, in the mountains. 3,500 feet.
What about your sunset, I think it would be? Do you have a good look at that?
It's too cloudy. You can't see anything.
Oh, okay.
That's why I got this.
Okay. Well, thank you for joining us and saying hello.
We might see sun on here sometimes.
Maybe. Or a spacewalk. Do you know
what time the sun is due to set from your location?
It's supposed to be in like 30 minutes.
And back to Allison.
Oh, wow, what's that?
I'm not quite sure. It's red. So,
I think it's the sun. Is it the sun?
Yes. One ST Westy has done something where we've got, it suddenly went all red. So, I'm going to move away from that. Oh,
are you there? Yeah, no, I'm going to leave for a while, mate.
All right.
Brilliant.
Thank you so much.
No, yeah, good to hear from you. Good to see you. And it's good to know people actually are in, on real life.
Yeah, thanks for contributing, dude.
Yeah, thank you so much.
I might come back. It's 5:43 is our sunset, so if I'm available, I might come back on.
Excellent. Please do. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yep. Cheers. Have a good day.
Bye.
I've got some info for you on the New Zealand sun whenever you're ready for it.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Okay, so I was busy, but then this got quite exciting, so I've come back. Essentially, what time and date is telling us at the moment is that the sun's direction is 358 degrees north, an latitude of 29 degrees. Okay, so has everyone heard that? You got that? Antonio, are you recording that?
Yeah.
Yeah, cool. So my own physical observations are using my iPhone calibrated compass. I'm looking at the sun at 336 degrees northwest at an altitude of... I haven't got any way of measuring this, okay? So I'm sticking my arm right up in the air. And I'm trying to do the degrees as best I can. I'm getting between 45 and 50 degrees, easily more than 45 degrees.
Wow.
So there's a discrepancy from what I am. You know, I'm going to emphasize, I'm not taking the angle of the sun scientifically. I'm doing it by my eyes, by my experience, my world experience, my experience of observing the sky, and so on. Okay.
So can you read those again?
Yeah, so I'm observing it at 336 degrees northwest.
Yes.
At an altitude, an inclination, you know, of between 45, 50 degrees, definitely more than a 45 degree angle. I'm saying 45 to be on the safe side, but it's different to what I'm looking at right now on time and date.
Yes, on time and date it says, was it 23 degrees?
29 degrees.
29 degrees.
And 358 degrees north. Now, you know, that's a big difference on the compass point, you know.
It is. So yours is 336 northwest.
Yeah.
Theirs is 358
north.
Wow. That's a huge difference.
Well, I mean, we're in kind of an uncharted territory a bit here because we're actually coordinated across the world, which is fantastic. So we have to make sure that we don't jump readily to the conclusion we want to find. We just have to be as methodical and as scientific as we can so that we can present to the people that are interested in this, the people that are watching this, the people that are listening, and the people that are going to want to challenge us on what we're saying, so that we're presenting the best we can to the world. Because, today, you can't do anything yesterday, you can't do anything tomorrow, we can only do it today, and today we're doing it. So let's do it good.
So, according to the official, the sun is here, but according to yours, the sun is more like here, or your orientation is different.
Exactly. It's whatever it is, it's different.
Yeah. So we had somebody from Norway saying that it was directly due north, the midnight sun. They've got the midnight sun right now. Oh, and he showed the sky. Did you see it?
Back onto the hangout, Norway.
Yeah. Yeah. So he was directly north, which tells us that your reading is more correct than the standard, the official reading. It's directly north. It's northwest. From your point, not north from your point. North from your point would bring it to there.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, from my own personal point of view in terms of the azimuth map and the globe, Yeah. I don't hold stock in either. So yeah. I find it difficult, you know, it's hard for us to look at the azimuth and to go, this is what we're seeing, because we don't know that what's under our feet is what's on the azimuth map.
Yeah.
So this is, we can speculate and we can say if we take this as the temporary model of what we're discussing, we can show the variation between the two. So I just wanted to be clear on my view on that.
Yeah, that's brilliant, and you're right. With the data that we're going to collect, we can start to establish where things are, because we know that this is distorted. We know that the globe is distorted. For thanks to this being synchronized, you know, when people are showing the sun, it's at the same time as I'm viewing it, or Patricia, or anybody else around the world. Mm-hmm. So this is like synchronized sun watching,
and it's how. Can you guys hear me?
Yes, yes. Eric.
Hey, I just want to let you know it is right here, the sun setting directly to my west. I'm actually right now in Smithfield, North Carolina. It's setting that way over there. It's been storming really bad, but it actually just went down.
Where are you located?
Just north of Mexico, right around Fort Huachuca.
Okay. And what's your time there?
6 o'clock.
All right. 6 p.m. And the direction where the sun is. Do you have any idea?
I have a very good idea. That's why I built a 21-foot azimuthal equidistant map. So it gives me the direction pretty easily.
Oh my, this is amazing.
Yeah, it makes it a lot easier. So right away, obviously, this is perfect north, and that's brick number, let's see, what is it? 1, 9, 17, 25. So, as usual, northwest, perfect northwest.
Yeah, everyone's got one of those in their backyard. It's no big deal, right?
Yeah, all you need is a shovel, and some water. Yep.
Wow. We've got Ray here. Ray. It's not clicking. Oh, there we go. Hi. Hello. Ray.
I'm in the Bronx, New York.
Oh, wow.
Yes, I'm in the Bronx, New York.
All right. And right there, it's 9:04 p.m., I'm guessing, right? Right.
Yes, it is.
Hi.
Hi, Charlie. Say the earth is flat.
The earth is flat.
There you go. Nice job.
Thank you. Somebody who's been deprogrammed or not programmed. Good. So, Ray, what is the direction that the sun is from where you are, if you know?
I would say it's southwest of me. Southwest.
Mm. No.
Yeah, it is. It's amazing that I'm in Canada. I can still see the sun going away. He's in New Zealand, and he's got sun. That's halfway around the world. I mean, I shouldn't be seeing the sun at the same time. I mean, it's halfway around the world.
No, Antonio's got the Gleason's map. What do you think? What does the map say?
Where is he, in Canada, east or west?
Well, it's heading out west. Of course, I'm in the east mostly. I'm on Eastern time.
So is this your sun that we're looking at?
That's Ottawa, and that's the sun. And I'm in the northern hemisphere and in the eastern part of Canada. I mean, and this guy's in New Zealand, and he's looking at a nice full sun, and we still see the sun in the northern hemisphere here. I mean, that's live right out my window here. I mean. The sun must have a magic wraparound or something going there.
Yes.
There's even in this sunset, there's no terminator line. Yeah, I never see a sunset from any altitude that has a long horizontal line that moves straight across the horizon. There's no terminator line with this type of sunset.
Robin Poe's got her globe out.
I mean, NASA shows a Terminator line. They've got it in people's brain. Where do you see a Terminator line on a sunset like this? This is more like a ball lamp or a can lamp moving across a table or a surface. Yeah. It's pulling away. It can only illuminate what's beneath it.
Looks like the sun is about here, where I have the top of my pen.
Is it below the equator?
No, it's above the equator in the Tropic of Cancer.
Wow.
It's just gone past midday in New Zealand.
That's 1:24.
You're looking north in New Zealand.
1:24 in New Zealand, and the sun is exactly north.
What time did you say?
1:24.
1:24, okay. So exactly north. Okay, yeah. In line with the guy from Norway earlier.
So really, that should be your kind of solar midday, right? I mean, if it's directly north.
Yes, it should.
So north it is 6:31 where you are? Maybe wrong.
Correct.
Okay, 6:31 p.m. in San Jose. Yep.
That's right. So I thought it was interesting that the gentleman in New Zealand could see it. And I can see it too.
Insane.
And the gentleman in Thailand can see it too.
Yep. Yeah. That doesn't work on a ball.
It doesn't at all. I'm looking at Google Earth now and it's impossible.
I mean,
wow, that's good.
I'm an hour drive from the Atlantic Ocean and I can still see the sun going over the Pacific. You know what?
We have Arlene here. Hi.
Hey, Patricia.
How are you?
I'm doing good. I'm calling in from Guam. I had actually gone on with Nathan.
I heard you earlier.
It was like, I think, 6, almost 8 o'clock, 6 till 8.
Yes.
This morning. So right now it's about 11:30 a.m. here on Guam.
Guam.
All right. And what direction are you? Or where, I mean, where's the sun exactly? Do you have any idea?
It's pretty much directly above me.
Yeah.
And the bearing is about northeast. North-northeast.
It's 5:30. I watched the sunrise 2 days ago from here. So I know it's coming from here.
Yes. So, Robin, it's 5:30 in Ankara. If you write your time down and her time down, you'll be able to keep track.
No, it's 5:30 exactly. It's 5 time plus. You know, the clocks are really synchronized.
23. Yes, 5:23.
It's 5:23 here. Yes.
Yes. Okay.
In
Ankara, Turkey.
I see. Yes.
Listen, nice to meet you, Dilara. Everybody else, Knight of the Round Fable, how you doing, mate? I'm going to drop. I'm going to see you all later, okay?
Nice to meet you.
Bye.
Nice, thanks, Dilara. Is that northeast, did you say? Northeast, right? There. Oh, look at that sunrise with Dilara. Your sunrise is beautiful there.
Yeah, it's half sunrise now. It's like and really beautiful. It's like golden in color. It's really beautiful. I can get up early and watch every day, I think.
All this is being recorded, right? Someone's making a list of all of this data.
Yes.
Yeah, there'll be various different people making a list, but this is being recorded. It's going to be available immediately after each hangout. They're going to be available. The day after, all of them will be available. So that's when I will sit down with pen and paper and take all the notes down.
Yeah, is anybody gonna kind of get it into some kind of table form and then put it up on the internet so I can look at it and cool, man.
Elliot's got a sunset here. We better pay attention to Elliot here. Sorry.
I've been so excited about this all week.
I know, it's cool, isn't it?
We're gonna have to do this again.
Yes, we are.
Oh, I was helping you honest. Hello, David.
Hey there. switching screen.
I wish I could convince this guy to unmute. Yeah, is it switching screens?
No, I'm good. I'm good now.
Okay.
I plan on filming the sunrise at 5:27, so 6 hours from now.
Cool. Hey, David. Hi, hey. Everyone. Can I just share screen, please?
Yes.
Robin.
Yes.
Okay. I'm just going to clarify something. It's for Rob. Oh, why am I not screen sharing?
You want me? Do I need to give you screen share or?
I don't know. It's not working. It's not allowing me to screen share.
Hey, I see everybody's icon and no one's image, no one's video. But if I go to the actual broadcast, I could see everybody's camera. Do you know how to change that? Like in the Hangout, it's everyone's icon, but in the broadcast, it's everyone's video.
Well, okay, I don't really have an icon. I just have the camera going, I guess, outside, right?
Yeah, you do.
I have an icon?
No, you have the camera running.
Oh, yeah, but no icon. Well, an icon that says you.
Yeah.
It's all black.
Well, that's okay. Hey, David, can you try to display camera? I just want to see whether it's just me that's messing up.
You mean display... I'm on camera, right?
Share screen.
Share screen.
Screen share. Yes, you can. Okay. Will you do me a favor? I can't screen share for whatever reason. Will you go to timeanddate.com, the sun and moon map, day and night map?
What is it, time and date? Oh.
.com.
Yeah. Okay, and then we'll go where? I'll share screen while I'm going.
Okay. So day and night world map. So you want to go to the menu on the sun and moon?
Where am I looking?
Top.
Right here?
Yeah.
Then what?
Go to sun and moon, day and night map, third from the bottom. Yeah. Now, will you go to suncalc.org?
Another webpage, another page.
Yes, please.
Okay,
so will you expand out? So hit the minus button at the bottom. Okay. Now will you click back to timeanddate.com? So look at the position, okay? Let's go from the UK, yeah? From the UK to the sun, right now, is southeast, is it not? David?
From the UK to the sun,
is southeast.
Correct.
Right, now go to suncalc.org. Put the flag on Britain, on the UK. Oops. Say something, David, it's cut away from you.
Can you hear me now?
Yeah. In the UK, to your left, above Spain. Up, left, 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 left.
Other left?
Other left. That left a little bit more.
Right here. No.
There. Drop it there.
Yeah.
Okay. Now move the scroll bar at the top You need to say something.
The scroll bar. What scroll bar?
At the top. You see that yellow and grey bar? Yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. You said to the US. Take it back to where it was, please. Back over, all the way over.
Okay.
I keep talking. It keeps going. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Yep. It's just about to rise. Yeah? In the UK.
I guess so.
Yeah. Move it over to the right a little bit more. Okay. That's when it's just risen. Yeah?
Correct.
Now, go back to the other timeanddate.com. Robin, you need to mute your mic when you're doing things because every time you make any noise, it cuts to your camera.
Maybe I can present. Am I? I think.
Okay. Sorry about that.
Am I presenting now?
Yes. So, timeanddate.com is showing the sun being southeast from the UK. Yeah.
Southeast.
Yes. SunCalc is showing the sun northeast from the UK.
That's so crazy.
When people say that SunCalc, that timeanddate.com is displaying things correctly, no, it is not. Okay, timeanddate.com says that the sun, if you go back to timeanddate.com, says the sun is just approaching China and is southeast from the UK. Okay, but when the sun rises in the UK, SunCalc, the other program, tells you how the sun rises. It rises from the northeast, not the southeast. And this breaks the globe model. SunCalc, this, suncalc.org versus timeanddate.com. They're showing two very different things. This is showing the actual azimuthal orientation of the sun from the UK, northeast. Timeanddate.com is showing a general roundabout of where the sun might be. So timeanddate.com is showing the sun where it actually is in relationship to the surface of the Earth. That's where the sun is. The map has been flattened out and set like this. Okay? If we make a circle of this map, so join Alaska to the Bering Straits with a large circle in the middle for the North Pole, we still have this, only when we've done that, the sun is northeast from the UK, not southeast. Do we got that?
Yeah.
Okay. So, the world is flat, guys.
I'm wondering that... Yeah. When, because the Earth is flat and the sun is right now pretty close to the Tropic of Cancer.
Yes.
You see how the sunrise and sunset really swing back and give us a long, long day.
Uh-huh.
And then when you bring it down, it becomes much wider. It widens out here. It's yes. A much bigger angle.
Yes.
If the Earth was round, wouldn't we have to have that short angle going down like this in December? Wouldn't the sunrise and sunset, when we're down here, be coming from the southeast and the southwest?
It does. It does. The sun goes... Can you see you've got two bars going... up and to the left, red, and up and to the left, orange. Up and to the right, orange. Yeah, from the pin.
Yeah.
So it in Cape Town in South Africa, it will come up at the top of the orange and make that short arc to the top of the red. So a shorter day. But still the 3rd of July.
Yeah, but can we change this to December? Where do we change the date?
Sure, you go to it says 3rd of July. Yeah.
Do I have to hit enter or something?
No, you hit where it says 3rd of July. Yeah. Carry on talking, David. It keeps cutting away from you.
I'm here. It says July.
Go down.
And pick the month.
December, pick the 21st or whichever day you want to pick.
Yep.
There you go. Okay, so that's it. I'm going to leave you with that, guys. Okay, I just wanted to point out that timeanddate.com is displaying the sun where it is in relationship to the surface of the Earth. Now, if we join the Bering Straits to Alaska, so we take Alaska, we wrap it round the top of Time and Date to, basically, we make it into a circle. The sun will still be approaching China, but it would be northeast from the UK, whereas the way it's represented now is southeast.
Interesting.
Yeah, it's because we don't live on a globe. That's why.
It means the sun's a lot closer than 93 million miles, too.
Absolutely. And here we have a globe. I don't know if the camera's is coming on me. Okay. So, is the camera on me? Yeah?
Yeah, you got your finger on the globe.
Yes, I have.
The representation globular of
supposed to live. I have my finger where the sun is. Now, according to Time and Date.
Hello, can I say something, Antonio?
Sure.
Well, I just want to say I'm Elisa, and we're in Scotland here, and the official sunrise should have been about 4:27, but it started getting light about 2:00 in the morning.
I know.
And then we're actually hitting at 25 degrees northwest.
Yes. Yes.
You did a blinding job, by the way, Robin. Thank you so much.
Just wanted to wish everybody love, strength, and courage. Cheers, everybody.
Yeah, thanks, Elisa Brittany, by the way. Nice to meet you. Okay, so guys, let me show this, okay? I'm holding the globe according to summer in the north, okay? So you, the viewer, is the sun, okay? This is the sun. The UK, I'm going to put my finger on the UK, is here, okay? It's already daytime. This is the orientation, okay? The part that is lit is, let me see, the part that is lit is this part. So it's lit like this and all the way around there, okay? So let me just show again. There's the sun. It's lighting up this much of the globe, this part of the globe, okay? And for you, being the sun, to be able to see the UK and the US, you can't see it from there, okay? You would have to do this, and that is not 23 degrees, okay? We are now there. That's the orientation, okay? Can we all see? This is summer in the northern hemisphere. And the sun is around here, but it's reaching all the way to here. Let me show you how much of my finger you can't see. And here.
Yep.
We don't live on a globe, guys.
That's a lot of coverage, eh? That's a lot of coverage.
I'm going to try to get a sparkle of the sun out the window here. It's just starting to go down. Can you see the little sparkle of the sun between the trees?
You haven't presented yourself, unfortunately, Robin. This is the one time you do want the camera on yourself.
Okay, there we go. So can you see the sparkle in the trees there? Like kind of a little sparkly thing?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, yes. That's the sun. It's It's about 5 degrees from the horizon now, so we're getting there. I may not be able to get the exact sunset, but that's about as close as I can get for now. I might be able to get it a little later.
Hey, y'all, man.
Hello, is that Darren?
Hey, that's me.
Hey, how are you? Thank you for joining us. So, where are you?
I'm in Sydney, Australia, Castle Hill.
Wonderful. And what time would it be there?
It's about 5:10 in the afternoon. We're looking at a sunset here.
It's beautiful.
Looking straight to the west.
Straight to the west?
Yeah.
Okay, great.
Pretty much west. I'll just tilt you. Sure, just give me a second. That's west.
Okay. We sure have had some great people jumping in here, sharing their footage with us. This really is a group effort, isn't it? A community effort. It's remarkable. I'm so impressed. So this is the sun here in London. Mr. Flat Taxi. Oh, and we have Arlene is back.
Flat Taxi!
Yeah, sorry. Second disconnection.
Oh, that is just gorgeous.
So if you're joining us in the chat, thank you very much. If you are experiencing either sunset or sunrise at your location, please click on the link below the video, share your sun with us, tell us your location, and hopefully further to that, direction and time and various other good stuff. But yes, click on the link if you're experiencing sunrise or sunset and share your sun with us. It will be extremely useful. Lots have done it to date. We have got lots of people who have shared various different sunrises and sunsets. What's most fascinating is obviously as we've got suns in our footage now, we may not have continuous feeds. It's been pretty good so far. We've had lots and lots of coverage of suns, which is absolutely fantastic. But hopefully someone joins from a point across the plane, on the globe, in the cell earth, whatever you want, and shows us anomalies that shouldn't necessarily take place. So you may think at your location, well, the sun's been up for half an hour, is it really worth sharing? Absolutely. Same if it's sort of night time, if the Teresa Gordons of the plane, they're listening in and they're thinking, oh, it's just too dark to share. It's always worth sharing. So yeah, I'm going to sign out now in the... Oh no, Robert!
There he is.
Perfect timing.
I did time it well.
Hey, Robert.
I've been watching all along anyway, so it's not like I wasn't there.
Hey, I figured as much.
What I will do is I will leave this hangout, and when you do leave, Jason, just make sure the last thing you do is unclick everybody so it's, you know, open to be controlled by Robert when he picks up and you leave. And last thing when you do leave is click the X in the right-hand box. But I'll leave this now so you can do a handover without me. I'll be listening in, but with a long delay from my, you know, camera phone that's in the other room.
Right on, Nathan. How's it going, Robert?
Yeah, good, thanks, Jason.
Good, good. So you've been watching, right?
Yeah, it's been some fantastic pictures of the sun so far.
Yeah, remarkable stuff. I think we'll have some information here worth talking about, worth analyzing, right?
Yeah, we'll be able to pick up a lot of data from that, and, you know, time, location, and where the sun is and where it's not, or where it should be.
Exactly. Oh, and we have Allison Craig joining us.
Good morning. Hi.
Welcome. That is one gorgeous picture you've got there.
Isn't it? And it's so sad that I've never come out here to see it in my entire life of living here. I just sleep and then I go to work.
Oh, gosh. So where are you?
This is Plymouth, Massachusetts.
Oh, wow. Man, that is flat.
Isn't it? Wow. Yeah, it's pretty flat.
Nice. Okay. What time would it be?
It is 4:44-ish.
Wonderful. Do you know by any chance what direction you would be facing now?
I'm pretty sure this is east, because this is like the Atlantic Ocean.
Okay. And we have, is that Adam?
That's Adam Douglas.
Adam.
Yeah.
Hey, how you doing?
Yeah, good, thank you.
Yeah, I'm kind of early, so I'm going to mute it for a bit. I might pop back in. Do I have to log back in when you take over, Robert?
No, you just carry on. You'll be okay. Fine.
Yeah, I got my coordinates, but it's going to be a little bit of time, but I went to a park down the road where I think it's going to give a really nice sunrise.
Yeah, wow. You can see it poking out now.
Yeah, it's just starting, and it's northeast, and my coordinates... If I can read it in here, is latitude 43.50637 and longitude negative or minus 80.49498. And I'll mute it for a bit. If I log out, I'll log back in.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
See you soon then.
Now, guys, one thing I was interested in doing for the record, if you'd like to. Is a slow pan across the coastal horizon from here, which we can almost get 180 degrees from where we are.
Great.
Well, if it's very flat.
It sure does look flat.
So this is, that's looking almost due north, and I will pan that very slowly so we can adjust for the sun. To get to this position, which is due west. Southwest. And then we're cut off about there, about south there. So that is, it's not quite 180 degrees, but holding the camera steady, that looks pretty flat to me.
Yeah. Have you ever tried watching sails ship out from this point, or ships?
We do. We've got the port of Fremantle just nearby. So the ships come from. Well, they come in from where the sun's setting at that point, and they come in through this way, and the port's just hidden over to the left there. One thing I wanted to do was get. I did find a website which shows where the ships are positioned, but. I didn't find a good enough one that was plotting it on a map, and I wanted to be able to have that map open so I could see exactly how far they were away from the coast where I was, right here, and then be able to photographically
The only way I
get the vision of them.
Is starting with it close and watching it go away and knowing its knots, right, knowing the speed, and then filming it for a certain amount of time and determining that way. I don't know how else to really...
Well, I like the idea of having the P900 and watching it disappear and then reappear. But I'm not packing that sort of technology.
No, me neither.
So Robert's in Canada. Allison, you're in the USA.
Plymouth.
And so is Rick.
Yeah.
Yes.
How you doing?
I'm Canadian too, man.
And so is Adam. Adam's got his footage going as well, which is.
Wow, that's really bright, man. Is that too bright for you guys, or is it all right?
No, that's okay. We can still see it clearly. We've got Suzanne coming in as well. Hello, Suzanne.
Hello.
Hi, how are you doing?
Good. I'm in South Korea, and it's overcast. It's been overcast all day, so there is no sun to be seen. So I was wondering how much longer this is going to be going on.
It will be going on.
I thought maybe I could wake up early and try to catch the sunrise tomorrow.
Most definitely. Yeah, if you can come back on when your sun... Rice is definitely, that would be awesome. There, it's running for till it's nearly 12 in the UK at the moment, and it's running till 10 o'clock tonight, so many, many more hours to go.
Yeah.
So, yep, if you want to come back at sunrise, then
yeah.
Sunrise, sunset, that'd be brilliant.
All right. Okay. Hopefully I can catch the sunrise.
Yeah, that'd be lovely. And then we'll get some sunrise sunsets from Korea then. South Korea.
Yeah.
Be good.
See what I can do.
Well, it's much appreciated, right. And look forward to your call later then.
All right, thank you.
Okay, thank you. Take care.
Take care. Bye-bye.
Goodbye. So, yep, more people linking in. Sergey, how's your... we've got some great footage now. Right. So, what direction are you facing? If you could tell us that, Sergey, that would be wonderful. If you can hear me.
The direction must be south now. South almost now. South.
Okay.
It's 6:55 here in Florida, Bradenton, and the sun should be rising where I could see it here soon, and it's about 148 south degrees on the compass.
Fantastic. If you could give us your time, date, and location, and where you think the sun's pointing, that would be...
Okay, I can hear now. So,
okay.
I am I'm in Pensacola Beach, Florida.
Brilliant. That's awesome.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you loud and clear, and we're looking at your camera at the moment. It's we can see the sun rising. That's wonderful because we've got Thailand sunset and sunrise.
Okay, I am you want longitude?
Anything you can give us with the time, date, location, and direction of sun or angle, it will help. But you don't have to give it all, it's just time and location, and that's brilliant. Whatever you can do.
The time...
Yeah, we can just hear you breaking up a bit at the moment. But we can see you clearly. You can see the pictures perfectly, but the audio is a little choppy. But that's not a problem because we're seeing the sunrise and you couldn't get a better shot than looking at the flat water ahead with the sun coming towards us.
I can get my location.
Yeah, no, the image is awesome. I just cannot, we cannot hear you. Your voice is quite muffled. It's probably the connection. Yeah, the image is fantastic, so that makes up for it. The other way to do it is if you want to be able to get clearer talk is if you mute your visual image and then just talk into that. You might be able to tell us a bit clearer where you are and the time and date, because it didn't come through too clear, and it will help everyone watching where you are.
Hello,
who's that?
Hello, sorry about the noise. Can you hear me?
Can you hear me? Can we see pictures of your subject?
Okay, this is...
Oh, wow, lovely.
Yeah. Okay. All right, this is Steve Taylor in Koh Samui, Thailand. It's, hold on, 6:05 at the moment. And it's the sun is going down in a roughly northwesterly direction. Northwesterly direction. Okay. And it's not due to actually set below the horizon for... another nearly half an hour, but this, as you can see, it's just about to hit a bank of cloud. So I thought I'd get it in quickly while you can actually still see the sun.
Yeah, thank you.
And also, you can see that the line of the reflection is straight on a flat water right across. Okay, so there's no little bit of reflection, it's the whole lot, and that goes for miles and miles and miles. I will come back again when it sets. Can you still hear me?
We can hear you loud and clear, yep.
Alright, I will come back when it sets and see what the light is like then, but I don't think the sun will be visible anymore.
I think it's just, it's so exciting to see the sun in different locations at different things and then it not matching up. It's that's the
Have you noticed at all that when people do midday shots, is the sun generally larger?
The sun, well, it certainly, it looks larger. It looks larger from the images. You know, and if it's anything to go by perspective, then you know, it probably is larger. It's probably closer as well.
Yeah.
Hello, Rob.
Hey, good morning, Antonio. How you doing?
Hey, I'm doing Antonio. Good. Hi, Nick. Do you need to go to the loo or anything? I just thought I would come in and man it for a second and just in case.
I would love to. In 5 or 10 minutes, it would be awesome.
Yeah?
So what I'll do is I'll unclick and you've already got access to this, I presume, yeah, or not?
No, I've come in as myself.
Okay, that's no problem. It's fine.
Yeah, if you leave it so that nothing is highlighted, when people come in, I will just ask them to speak, and when they speak, it will cut to their camera.
Wonderful. Well, I'm only going to be like a few minutes, so I'll literally just going to have a drink and a toilet break, and then I will be back.
Enjoy.
So, yeah, I'll kind of keep it closely monitored in case people decide to jump in that shouldn't be. I'll be back shortly.
Okay.
I'll just mute myself.
Okie doke.
Very thoughtful of you, Antonia.
By the way, I hear for the people in chat that there's a troublemaker in the chat. I think it's called GeoShifter. We'll fix it. Don't worry, guys.
Hey.
I'm joking! We've definitely found some discrepancies, haven't we?
Yeah.
The sun was going down from Western Canada and Western US, Northwestern, and also Hawaii.
Yes,
we were going down at the same time.
Yeah.
Been a few of those, Antonio. It's been quite good.
Yes. So it's going to help us lay things out. And this is what a lot of globalists don't want, because when we have a map that works better than any of their globes, you know, because right now their biggest bugbear is that we don't have a map. But we can't have a working model. Say, okay, well, we have the real world, so we can just watch the real world, and that's what we're doing. You know?
It couldn't get any simpler to make it clearer just by everyone watching, but luckily we've got the technology to be able to link up and do this live like this. It's good.
Yeah.
And the time has come.
It should have been done a long time ago, but again, the time is now, and that's this is where we are.
Things happen when they're supposed to.
Exactly.
You know, early on, a lot of people, you know, like 2 years ago, people were saying, well, do something. And we had to have that natural kind of ebb and flow and people to settle into something, you know. And I remember talking to Flat Earth British Martin, and we were both talking about having it in our heads that we could envision meeting flat earthers in the flesh, and that's happened.
Wow.
That's already happened.
Oh, it has. It's been amazing for me. I've got friends locally that could have been good friends for 20, 30 years. That type of people, wonderful.
Right. But watching that happen from here was quite magical. Also, a very natural progression. There's no harm in taking things slowly, because the only one thing you can guarantee is that the sun will come up and the sun will go down. And
that's it. And we don't have any rush. There's no rush, you know. Let's face it. If we let's say in day one, somebody came out with everything, the model, the map, everything, it will still take NASA and the established authorities a long time to divorce themselves of their model. So they will have to divorce themselves, but they're going to need time to do it. So it's just as well that we're taking our time too.
Yeah.
Now we've got Steve. Steve coming.
Hello.
Hello, Steve. How are you doing?
Hello, Robert.
Hello.
The sun did die.
It's like you this did is this.
Yeah, with the clouds.
Yeah, and I'll just say hello to Nick, Phuket World.
Hey, man.
Yeah, we're over in Samui, not too far from you. And that the sun has died. I was hoping it would go into the ocean, but not. But it looks like there might be a nice after sunset.
I reckon you're going to get some nice red.
Yeah, I've got my real camera with me as well. So anyway, it's been a great day today watching everyone, and good luck with the results. So I can't wait to see how it all pans out. So anyway, good luck, Antonio. I can see you smoking away over there in your halo.
I am.
And and thanks to you too. All right, be in touch and look forward to the chats after.
Yeah,
all right,
it's been
all
a pleasure speaking to you, Steve. Thank you.
Take care, Steve.
Yeah, cheers now. Bye-bye.
Bye. So have you seen how many people came on from Florida? One thing that this is showing me is how many people there are out there. You know, not just Flat Earthers, but Flat Earthers happy to go on a hangout and show their son. You know, it seems like we were getting lots of people from Florida. You know, it's various different people from the different areas. Like now,
really, really nice people on. We've had the occasional troll kind of thing, but that's
yeah,
to be expected.
Yeah, when I came on and Patricia was on, we had one then. Just,
oh, right. Yeah, Nathan had one when I come in the morning.
it's nothing. We could just kick him, you know.
Yeah, I gave him a little bit of time. Not too much.
Yeah.
Yeah, hi.
I'm Errol. I'm Amanda's husband.
Errol.
I'm using her phone.
Wonderful.
Hey, so I'm in Boulder, Colorado, and the sun's just coming up here.
Oh, fantastic.
Cool.
Wow. It's just setting with me in Phuket right now. It's coming up with you.
Yeah, I'm going to show it just coming around the corner here.
What's your time?
Right now, it's 5:44 a.m., and the sun is not even, the disk is not over the horizon yet. But,
oh, wow. That's a fiery sunrise.
There we go.
So it's setting in Thailand and rising here.
5:44 a.m. right now.
Brilliant.
So here, I'll keep walking towards it. There we go. How are you guys?
All good.
Very well, thank you. Yeah, it's been amazing, some of the photos.
How's the experiment?
It's going well. Going very well.
Great.
Yeah, we found some pretty major discrepancies with the maps. This map, as well as the globe, is completely destroyed. What we've done has completely, utterly destroyed the globe, like, without any shadow of a doubt.
Yeah.
The case of adjusting these or figuring out what the actual shape of the sunlight is, because the sun was setting in Western Canada and setting in Hawaii.
Wow.
Yeah.
Yeah, so, that is strange.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But it's going to help us...
So it's the... Yeah.
It's going to help us plot the place.
It will. We'll be able to say sun there, land there, land there. And
yeah,
that's how
is the idea to have like a big one of those Gleason maps and just kind of put some push pins in there at certain times and give you a little map of the pattern?
Yes. We're also, this was really a trial. So we're going to do it again, you know, at specific times in the year. So midwinter, midsummer, equinox, to see where things are. But this was really just to see how we could work it, how many people might participate, what things we can start to establish. So we know that we can start to establish the shape of the sunlight, so how the sunlight falls on the earth, and where places are. So,
right.
Yeah, so it's very cool.
Excellent. So you said earlier that it's setting in Thailand right now?
Yeah.
It's basically, it should be at the horizon. If I was at the beach, it would be sinking into the horizon right now.
Wow.
It's 6:46, so 2 minutes time is the official sunset time for me.
Nice.
This is incredible stuff. It really is.
And we had a guy from Russia. We had somebody from Norway as well, showing the midnight sun. They really do have a midnight sun, not just a blue sky. They have the sun visible. It was at 69 degrees north.
Wow. Yeah, I guess, this is the time of the year when it would be there.
Yeah.
Hey, can you keep it on Amanda for a while? That's really sweet.
Here's Amanda's beautiful face.
Right here. Oh my God! You could get a job in Thailand at a bar.
Thank you. I'll accept that as a compliment.
Yeah, I'd buy you a drink.
Thanks, man. I don't know if you can see the mountains behind me there, but that's
beautiful. Yeah, it's lovely.
I'm not talking about that.
There's the sun.
Guys, so the mosque, this is interesting, the mosque just started up.
Oh, wow. I just hear it in the background almost.
So they've got it, they've had it down pat all day from sunrise, midday, or not midday, but the solar noon, which was 12:30, and right now, which is exactly sunset. Can you hear it?
Yes.
Yes, you can. Hear, hear.
Guys, check out those sun rays. Check out those sun rays.
Move your camera to Rita.
Sorry?
Yeah, it's nice crepuscular rays there.
Hey. I'm not videotaping you, I'm videotaping the sun. Yeah. Well, the mountains are the other way. Yeah. The sun's over there, and the mountains over there. We're on a flat Earth hangout. We believe the Earth is flat, and we're.
Oh, look at his face!
Yeah. Yeah, look into it, man. YouTube Flat Earth. It's like really interesting. There's some good stuff. Yeah. No. Yeah. Just check it out. All right. Peace.
I see it for you.
Nice.
That's how you do it.
Yeah, that's how you do a live chat with. Filming the sun and then instructing people.
Spreading the word.
You know what? The first time my wife went to saw a sci-fi movie, she said, "Is the Earth really like that?"
What did you say to her?
Well, of course, at the time, this was before anything Flat Earth came along, I said, "Well, yeah." But now when I talk to her, it's right, now she knows I'm on the right track.
Yeah, this is the thing. Like, anybody asking, if we'd not come across Flat Earth, we would say, yeah, that's what it's like.
Yeah.
But we never start to think, yeah, that's what we're shown that it's like. Yeah. Like, people who have theories and, you know, CGI.
Yeah.
It's like, wow. It's just how the trick of authority is so good.
It's very clever, isn't it? Very clever.
Yeah.
But do you know, I mean, when you talk to globeheads, for want of a better word, they I don't know, can some people just really not see it?
Yes, but it's not their intelligence that can't see it, or their perception, it's their ego. It won't let them.
Yeah, I know someone, a close relative, who said that he would even if he had all the proof in the world, he would still say the Earth was a ball if he had a gun to his head.
Yes. I had a Grobling friend of mine said to me, what would you do if you could go up on a rocket and see that it was a globe? I said, I would come back down and I would tell everybody, dude, it's a globe. I said, what would you do if you went up on a balloon and you saw it was flat? He said, my head would be mashed. I wouldn't have it.
Right.
Wow. Okay.
That's
wow.
what he actually said. I said, dude, did you just hear what you said? You know, his eyes were registering his memory from like 3 seconds ago. Yeah. And he was. I could see he was troubled by what he just said.
Yes, we've got from Bangladesh in India. It's Kenneth.
It's so Bangladesh. Hi, how are you?
Yeah, good, thank you. And if you could show us your sunrise and the sun.
It's bang. It's right behind those clouds there.
Ah, yeah. Okay.
It's gonna set in like half an hour. So.
And where are you?
I hope. Bangalore, India, Karnataka, Bangalore. India.
Not yes. Bangladesh, Bangalore, yeah. Okay. That's great, thank you. Brilliant footage. Yeah, stay on while the sun sets and we can capture that and film that as well at the same time.
And what time is it for you?
It's 5:45 IST. I think that's 11:15 GMT.
5:45. Okay. And it's, wait a second, it's setting, yes?
Yeah, it's setting.
Okay. Do you know what direction, what compass direction, what azimuth is setting?
So time and date tells me it's northwest.
Northwest?
Yeah, time and date.
Good, thank you. That's really helpful. And
brilliant, thanks.
All that's logged now, and then we know roughly where you are, what the sun is doing.
Yeah.
Hello, Robin. How are you doing?
Can you see my sunrise? It's really misty and cloudy, but you'll see just a light patch between those in the draw in the hills there.
Yeah, it's a good clear picture. That's great. And where will the sun be rising from where you are, Robin?
Okay, it actually has already started to rise. You can't see it through the clouds. It rose about 5:05, so that's because I had problems getting in. But it's coming up at about maybe 25 to 30 degrees off the north.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah, and if you want to get an idea of the direction, let me just go down here. This road here runs directly north to the north. So
Okay. You
can see kind of where the...
So it's northeast.
Yeah, so it's like, a little bit more north of northeast.
Yeah.
Like at about 25 degrees from north, not a full 45.
Yeah.
Maybe 30.
And you are in...
I'm just about 3 miles southwest of Newcastle, Washington. Or maybe 2 miles, yeah.
Oh, that's great, thank you. And we've got Scott. How are you, Scott? And where are you coming from? What's your location and where will the sun be rising?
Scott, actually, we are in San Diego, California, and the sun's going to be rising in the northeast. I do not know how to get the longitude and latitude of that location.
That's okay. We can figure that out later.
Yeah, just give him your location. That's all. It works.
The exact city is Vista. But it's in the county of San Diego.
Okay, Vista, San Diego, California.
Correct.
Cool.
Yeah.
What time is it likely to? What time is it predicted to rise?
I don't know for the exact time today, but I know it's been rising anywhere between 4:30 and 5:30. So right now is time. I don't have the exact time in front of me. Let me go grab my...
Is that overcast or just twilight?
Well, it is. It's a little overcast, but we're about 15 miles from the ocean, or about 10 to 15 miles from the ocean. So the sun will come through. The overcast starts to go away right as the rays of the sunshine start heating it up.
If only that would happen.
Oh. What'd you say?
I said, if only that would happen here in Seattle.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it stays gloomy or hazy down by the coast.
So it's already risen in Seattle? In California yet?
Well, not here exactly.
Interesting, huh?
Yeah, that is interesting.
Yeah, we have interesting sunrises and sunsets here. I've noticed. I don't know if it's our positioning on whatever we live on, whatever the shape is.
This is what one of the aims of this experiment is, to determine how people are oriented on the map. You know, I don't know if you can see, I have the AE map behind me, and we can establish from what people are telling us in terms of sunrise, sunset, and their location, in what way the AE map is wrong. We can start to establish how it's wrong. We know that it's wrong. We know that it's wrong in various different ways, but not all the details. So, for instance, now we know that you're much further west than Seattle, although on this map you're further east and you're further south. So the sun right. should have arrived at you before it did at Seattle.
Right.
Well, Antonio, I looked on time and date, and the angle of the sun coming up is about 30 degrees more north than it should be on time and date. It's a different location.
Yes. So what we saw from Nick Phuket Word is that his readings from time and date were very close, but he's very close to the equator. You know, he's definitely on the Tropic of Cancer. So it's easy for the readings to be correct there. But as we veer away from that, you know, the readings get more and more wrong. Like you just said, it's 30 degrees off from time and date to the real world.
Yeah, when time and go ahead.
Sorry. I was going to say, when you say Tropic of Cancer, are you referring to the stars?
No. Can you see behind me?
Yes.
Yeah. So we have the equator is here. It goes through the Sahara. Okay. And then we have the Tropic of Capricorn further south and the Tropic of Cancer further north. And now the sun is circling around the Tropic of Cancer.
Oh, okay. So it's the position.
Yes. So the sun oscillates back and forth. It goes around the equator. It swings out towards Antarctica. It swings in towards the North Pole, swings out towards Antarctica, back and forth. So the equator is the midway point between those two points, and the tropics, what we call these tropics, are where the deserts are. So we have the deserts of around the world. They're in the Tropic of Cancer and the Tropic of Capricorn.
Okay. How do they...
I'm gonna sign off, Antonio. My arm's getting tired.
All right. No.
Okay. Thank you, Robin.
I said it that way. That's funny. So how does Antarctica get the same sun that the Arctic gets?
No. One of the people we had earlier, sorry, Rob. Two people. One was in Russia, in Murmansk, and the other was in Norway. and they showed the midnight sun. They were showing the sun at after midnight. You know, it's visible above the horizon. And Antarctica, in the middle of the Antarctic winter, middle of the summer. Okay, so Rob, tell Vicky about the sun. So let me just establish, from Murmansk in the Russian Federation and from Norway, they had the midnight sun. From Norway, it was directly north. So they were seeing the sun. If you can see the map behind me.
Yes, yeah. You're highlighted at the moment.
From Norway, they were seeing the sun when the sun was here.
Wow. Okay.
So they were seeing it directly north.
Yes.
Okay.
Really? So,
yes. Yes. And we knew that the sun was here because we were in contact with Kofo, who's in New Zealand, and we were also in contact with somebody who's in Perth at the same time.
Well, that's interesting. So what are you going to do with all this data? Are you going to have some kind of simulated version of how everything was lit out at some point?
Well, somebody sooner or later who's good with computer graphics is going to do that. It won't be me. I will be tabulating the data. Lots of people will be tabulating the data. But there are people out there who are very skilled with models. And then hopefully, yeah, they will do this.
Gosh, that's so much time and effort. You guys, that's so nice of you guys to do all this.
Ah, well.
Volunteering, huh?
Yeah, but you're doing your part now.
Yeah,
everyone is has come and contributed video footage and given us their details and location and time. I mean, it's really valuable data, and it's appreciated from everyone.
So, Robert,
are you getting data and just it's on the video?
Yes, from the video, all the videos are going to be available, so anybody can just watch the videos and jot down the data as and when it's shown.
The reason we did
this continuously is that so that we wouldn't have time and date distort the information. Because if you're trying to tabulate data and you're working from time and date and sunlight saving time and all of these things, it's easy to get confused. If you start watching and you mark it from your time, okay? So as soon as somebody says the first time, you know what time it is where you are, and then just mark everybody's time, everybody's location, everybody's sun. It's easier because it's a continuous feed.
So the time now in the UK is 1:35 PM, and that's GMT plus. So that gives it another. That's why I keep pushing the time and date. So it logs what we're looking at, and it means the time is relevant rather than waiting 10, 15, 20 minutes between each person saying their time and date. So yeah, it's good, and it's really good footage actually. And we've got Wake the Sheeple 2016. How are you doing?
Good. Can you hear me?
Yeah, loud and clear and fantastic footage. Thank you. If you could give us your direction of where you're facing, your location.
I'm facing north, east, and then it will swing all the way down here, down to the south, ride all the way around these apartments, and then it cuts right back up to right where it is, northwest, when it sets.
And where are you?
St. George, Utah, USA.
And what time is it there now?
It's like, when I walk out, it's about 6:15 or 6 whatever. Not my clock on me there.
Thanks for that, Wake the Sheeple. Robert, before we go, Victoria's waiting to hear what the sun does in Antarctica in the summer.
It does a arc, that's what it does. And the arc is a northward arc, it's not a southern arc. I might have to rejoin because my Internet Explorer's just shut down, so I might have to come back very shortly.
Okay. But the sun rises and sets in the arc.
Yes, it rises in the north from position of where the South Pole is, supposedly marked, and the compass from that. So I will close this.
So it rises from the South Pole from Antarctica?
No, rising from the north side.
So if you look at the map
and you picture yourself on the edge facing inwards, that would be south to north. So your south would be at the back, north would be at the front. So in front of you, doing an arc.
Which part of the edge were you at? Were you located?
Around. If you look at the map, it was around here where I've got my finger.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
Almost in line with South America kind of thing.
Yeah.
Just skewed to one side of it.
Yeah.
Oh, interesting.
So the sun would... Robert would see the sun around here and stop seeing it around here at some point. You know, it might be further over. But this is what... the sun would describe this circle, but from Robert's perspective, it would come towards him like a plane flying towards you, go up and across and down, right to left, the opposite to when we're looking at the sun from the north.
That's correct, and that's from seeing the maps and then what I experienced. That's the best way to describe it. It's really interesting when you see all these sun anomalies, what we're watching today. It should give us a clearer, because it's never going to be clear. So I'm going to have to pop you off, Mr. Cornholio, because your camera's not showing.
Somebody boot me off too, because I ain't got no buttons to exit out.
Absolutely. All right, okay. Yeah, no problem. Wait, the sheeple. You're welcome to stay there for a bit anyway. It's not a problem.
I'm heading out. So I just wanted to get you guys this before I'm heading off. So
yeah, thank you, much appreciated. I will boot you out to say when, and then I'll do that.
Cheers to everyone.
Yeah, thank you. Take care, thank you everyone. Too. All the best. Okay. So back to the sunrises and sunsets we have.
That's very interesting. Did you see the sun in Antarctica for an entire year, except obviously when it gets dark, because it gets dark there, right?
Yeah, it does get dark, but it's not the darkness you think it is. It's a twilight darkness, and it's you can see the light. Again, it's in the northerly direction.
So, but just to make it clear, was there a midnight above the horizon sun
there was no sun that was directly above that kind of did the circle. That was the thing I didn't notice. Noticed it doing its horizon to horizon points, which is at the distance, but it never went all the way around at all.
Yeah, that is strange. I mean, it's supposed to, isn't it supposed to do that?
A lot of things. It's supposed to be in Hawaii at one point and Colombia in another, and it didn't do that when I think it was one of the chaps and another chap came in, and they was like, well, it should be this and it should be that, and that was nothing even related to this hangout. They were just particularly talking at that time a few days ago, and then they found out the information. And they were saying, well, the sun should be setting here at this time. And they were looking at time and date, and no, none of that matched up, which coincides with why we found a few things that have not matched up today. So, yeah, once we can group all that data together, get it to some kind of format which we can think, right, that's doing that at that time, and then start things where the sun would be, it would be really interesting to see. Whatever conclusion it is, whatever thing we decide and find out from facts that are presented for the video, it can only give us a clear indication rather than just doing absolutely nothing and then assuming, which is what we've done for the last however long you've lived.
Yeah. Well, one of the things that I've noticed, I'm trying to figure out how they got away with it with the globe for so long, where you have the sun setting in Canada and the sun setting in freaking Hawaii at the same time. It's setting at the same time in the real world, but if you try to work it out with data that's provided to you by globalists, they distort time. So they'll tell you that it's the next day or the day before. So you can't really plot Hawaii compared to Canada, you know, when you're looking at sunrise. So, and then you have the day and night map from time and date, and that's distorted that's definitely distorted because it shows the sun rising to the southeast of the UK, when in the real world it rises northeast from the UK. So what they've done with the time and date, night and day map, is they've taken this and they've basically spread it out sideways. That's what they've done. Well, not actually this. They've taken more or less a correct world and put it out side by side. That's what they've done. But who would have guessed that the sun sets at Hawaii at the same time as Canada?
Yeah.
No. Yeah, well, that's great. And that happened.
Well, and somebody else, I can't remember the other chap's name, but yeah, they were screaming about it and saying, look, it just doesn't make any sense whatsoever why that should be that with such a time discrepancy and such the location where it should be. It does indicate that the map is not what we think it is, and that does indicate that. Otherwise, it would be exact, and we wouldn't find any anomalies anywhere, and it would all be absolutely matching what we're seeing, and it's not doing so that's
one of the errors. Really interesting. One of the errors with this map is that this is taking the same map as we have on the globe generally and just displayed it from the north, okay? But the maps that we have on the globe are wrong. So this is wrong, and we know this. We know this for sure now, because this here, which is Hawaii, is not here. It has to be on the same latitudinal line as Western Canada and Western US, Northwestern US. It has to be. Otherwise, how's the sun setting there at the same time? So
that is mind-blowing. And
the biggest distortion on the maps, the biggest distortion on the maps is it here in the Pacific Ocean. This is where they've distorted the map the most. I mean, everything's distorted. These should be splayed. But this area here, this has been expanded.
Right. Yeah. Why would you do that? Do you know why? Do you have a reason why?
Yes. Because this is just my opinion. If it was displayed the way it really is, it would look too artistically balanced. People would look at the map and say, hold on a second, this looks like it's been designed with somebody with aesthetics in mind. And as it is now, it looks a bit more haphazard, you know, could be more of a natural process. But if it looks designed, if the three main bodies reaching down towards Antarctica are equidistant from each other, it looks too symmetrical. It will look too designed. And scientists don't like the world being designed because that calls for a designer.
Right.
Yeah.
That makes sense.
Yeah, so this is my opinion. I also think we
don't want to give you a reason to believe.
That's it.
They're always trying to get you to forget about the Bible and everything else to do with.
Even if you don't pay attention to the Bible, just the fact that it's designed tells you there's a designer, you know. Call him Yahweh, Allah, whatever you want to call him. It's still a designer. Whatever you want to call it. I don't think we should call it him, you know.
Right.
Because unless we're going to say his name is this, and her name. Yeah. Her name too, you know.
Yeah, that's
I have to so go good. Now.
Hey, Victoria.
Thank you very much, Victoria. You've been really fantastic. You've shown us some great footage. If you just give us your last time, date, and location just before you jump off, that will finish you. Thank you very much.
I'm in Red Boiling Springs, Tennessee. It is 7:46 a.m. Sunday morning, and it's been a cloudy morning. The sun is up, coming through the clouds there a little bit. Where it's light, you can see that. But I have a lot of blueberries to get picking at, so I need to get going. I will leave this on and be listening and popping over to look occasionally, but I need to shut off the camera now. So,
okay,
have a wonderful day. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Bye-bye.
Can I ask you a question?
Of course.
So,
as you might know, like, I've been trying to speak to my friends about this, and they are like hardcore globalists. So one of the things they asked was about the shine of the sun on the underbelly of a cloud. Uh-huh. And I had no idea what to say back to that at the time. So if you could share what...
What was that? Yes, I can help to explain. Okay, can you see my camera?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
It's on you.
Okay, so... Let me see how clear this is. Can you see? Right, I'll make this bigger. Okay? So, this is the sun, and this is the ground, and this is clouds. Okay, can you see? Can you see the clouds here?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, the sun travels like this. Can you see?
Yeah.
Yes?
Yeah.
You are seeing the clouds from further this way. You are further than the clouds. Yes? The clouds are between you and the sun. Yes? So no matter where the sun is, its angle to the clouds and to your eyes allows the clouds to be lit, what look like from underneath to us. They're actually lit from the side, but we only see the part of the cloud that is lit. So, and we think this is the underneath.
Okay, I'm just going to grab you for a second, Anthony. We've got Dahlia.
Hey.
Hi, Dahlia.
Dilara.
No,
Dilara.
I am. Hey, how are you?
Good.
Thank you. Whereabouts are you from?
I want to also connect. I am from Ankara, Turkey. We watched the sunset in the morning. Now the sun traveled all the way long up to here, and I wanted to show that. And I'm also going to connect with you for the sunset also. Fantastic. In a couple of hours.
Great, that's lovely. Thank you very much. And where's the sun pointing? Do you know the direction, north or south or east?
No. Okay. The sun has risen from northeast, gone through east, and then to south. Now it's going to the southwest direction, and I think it's under the clouds right now. But the cloud is really small. Maybe you will be able to see it.
Yeah, we can.
Can I show it?
It is on its side, but we can still see the footage, and that's really good.
And it's sky, and the sun is under the clouds. I'm not sure if I'm taking the sun right now.
Yeah, you're taking the sun right now. We're having to tilt our head 90 degrees, but that's okay.
Yes. Hello? And we can see it too. Okay. Can you tell us where you are, my friend?
Down here in Arizona.
Beautiful, mate. Keep talking. Unfortunately, the person who's got control of the camera has just nipped off for a moment, so we need you to talk just so we can see what you're seeing. Tell us as much as you can.
Okay, can you hear me now, Nathan?
Hear you beautifully. Just tell us where you are and what you've got in front of you. Oh, Antonio's back. Can you pop the camera on this chap and meet and greet Antonio? That'd be brill.
Yeah, I was just on a minute ago. My phone keeps overheating because of the sun. Yeah, so I'm in Tempe, Arizona. It's 7:38 a.m. I'm looking to the east. And I put a little filter over the phone here so I don't overheat this time.
Yeah.
I've overheated three times, so.
That's a cool image.
I didn't, looks pretty neat, huh?
Yeah. Yeah, it does.
We have a new guest. If you could just give us your son and your location, new guest.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, I'm in Kuwait, and Kuwait City, basically. Awesome. Yeah.
Can you share your son with us, please?
So, So the sun is going down. We're doing sundown here, and I'm not going to be able to do the whole thing right this second, but I'm going to give you a view for now, and then I'm going to go somewhere else and give you more views.
Brilliant. Thank you.
That's the sooner the better, because you may lose your connection at any moment, and so far all we've had your face. No offense. So I'm always
Yeah, I'm going to turn it around now. So here we go.
Okay. Oh, nice.
It's a bit sideways. If you can just change your camera back how it was a second ago, that's perfect. Well done. That's brilliant. Excellent. Lovely.
What time is it in Kuwait?
It's, hang on, just let me see.
Can you do it again? Can you keep it down for a moment? Antonio, can you pop the camera on her, please, so the people in the live feed get to see that, because they've all missed that.
Yes.
It's
6:34, and it's just about to set.
Yeah, because now it's Ramadan here, so everybody's fasting, so we pay a lot of attention to when the sun goes down, since we can eat when it goes down.
Yes. And what direction is it going down?
Well, the direction that it's in right now, I think, is like, it might be southwest. No, northwest, maybe.
Yes, northwest. Okay. You know, you said you were going to move.
Is there a way I can find out using my phone what direction it is?
For now, it's fine. Just leave what you've got is beautiful. Please just leave it exactly. Don't worry about looking anything up on your phone. If you can just give us the view you have, it's spectacular. We're so chuffed that you've joined us. And what you're giving us right this second is exceptional. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for joining us. Hopefully we can keep you as long as possible.
I'll be back. Don't worry. Before the sun goes down, I'll be back on. I just have to drive to somewhere else before I actually.
Okay. So whilst you're driving, before you rejoin us, are you using a mobile phone, an Apple phone, by any chance?
No, this is a Samsung.
Okay. If you look in your folders, in your settings, you might have a compass.
I'm going to look. If not, I can look at Google Maps and get the information.
Okay. Well, brilliant. Thank you very much. Ah, Nathan, who could have dreamed it?
Down to the people who've come by and just shared their sunrise. It's as simple as that. You know, just somebody coming in suddenly lifts the spirits of everybody. So, yeah, if you're watching this and going, man, that's pretty cool. Just if you've got your sun coming up or going down, or you just want to test out your kit, share some with us. It always lifts our spirits.
Yes. Did you hear, by the way, about Amir? He wrote in the chat earlier that he will take the data and create a model.
Yeah, he's been quite instrumental, and Amir's done us proud. You know, he's really been good. He's been moderating and doing all sorts of stuff. So yeah, Amir from Insanity is Sanity. A massive thank you to you. But loads of people have, you know, Bob from Globusters, you, all the people who've hosted these hangouts, Patricia Steer, Robert Shortman, Gav when he joins us when he hosts the next leg, whoever left out, Stephen Chess, Jason, who else? There must be, you know, loads of people who've actually joined, and they're the people that have really made the show, because without the people coming on, I didn't catch her name, she's just left us.
She's
But either way, she came, she shared her sunrise with us. Fantastic. Hello, new joiner. Who have we got? Mohammed, and we've got Back for More. Can you share your suns and tell us your location, friends?
Hey, Nathan.
Yes,
Mohammed,
I'm in
here
Bradenton, Florida, and I'm at 27 latitude, negative 82 longitude. And it's 11:40 right now, and the sun is directly above me, but the clouds are right there.
We've also got Mohammed. Can you tell us where you are and what your camera is?
Hey, yes, Mohammed here. I'm in San Diego, California, just testing, basically.
Brilliant.
Because my house actually overlooks a canyon kind of thing.
Yes.
So I get like a perfect sunset.
Oh, awesome. Will you be joining us when your sun is setting?
Yes.
Hello again. How are you doing?
I'm back.
You certainly are.
Can you hear me?
I can hear you, yes. I'm going to film as I drive. Oh, cool. Can you just tell us your location?
Kuwait.
And what's your local time there?
It's now 6:49.
Brilliant. Yeah, if you can share your sun with us.
Yeah, so I've already given you some of my sun when it was up higher, and now I'm just going to give it to you.
That's superb. Yes, brilliant. Thank you very much. I know you've tuned in before, but I'll periodically ask guests the whole time. And we've also got Annalie. How are you doing, Annalie? Can you tell us your location? We're getting your sun. We are getting your sun.
About 9:50 Mountain Standard Time. I'm in Provo, Utah.
Can you repeat where you are again, please, Annalie?
Provo, Utah, United States.
Superb. Absolutely superb. And did you give us your time? I think you did. Can you just repeat that again?
Yes, 9:50 a.m.
Excellent. Excellent. Will you be joining us later on for your sunset if we're still running?
Yes, we will be.
That's Mo just having a little mooch around, adjusting his camera. And there's the sun from Q8. This is tracking the sun on a flat Earth live. We have several cameras from across the flat plane sharing their view of the sunrise and sunset at their location. So hopefully if you do join in, just point your camera at the sun and tell us where you are. I may go back to reading a few chat comments if it's good by you. We've got the sun currently showing over Warwickshire, UK. Hopefully a few people will join us shortly with their sunsets or sunrises. In the meantime, it always seems to be Patricia at the top of the list, flat Earth under the hot potatoes. Yes, the FE community is brighter than the sun. Teamwork across the plane, love it.
Denver, Colorado, reporting in.
Yeah, welcome, Tim. How you doing, buddy?
I just got banned. I was just trying to share my sun with the flatties.
All right, man.
What's the time at your location, Cognitive Dissonance?
The time is 10:15 a.m.
That's superb.
Mountain Standard.
Thank you very much for sharing your sun.
Absolutely. Have a good one.
You too, man. Take it easy.
How you doing, Olga? Can you tell us where you're from?
I'm from Meridian, Idaho.
Cool. And can we see your sun if you turn your camera around 180 degrees? Flip it around so we can... So it's pointing at you at the moment. If you could just point it at your sun, that'd be brilliant.
Oh, yeah. Hang on.
Oh, and we've got Ogdina. I'll just put the camera on her for a moment. So that's Olga currently displaying. That's beautiful, Olga. Thank you very much.
And how about that?
Can you see anything?
Yeah, we've got you up, Dina. If you want to point it towards your sun, that would be brilliant. Nearly there,
I am.
Nearly there.
Can you see it?
Yeah.
You're kidding. I did it.
Yeah, great just stuff. Point it at the sun.
Is it at the sun? Because I can't see. The glare is too much.
Yes, we're seeing the sun. Yeah, we can see. Oh. Great stuff. Thank you, Olga.
I'm going to do this at
Olga
sunset.
Olga is. Ogdina isn't. Ogdina, you're not quite pointing at the sun, but Olga, you are. Brilliant work, Olga. Ogdina, not quite pointing at the sun just yet, but we're nearly there. You've got your camera on working, and we can hear you. Just need you to point directly at the sun.
Aren't I?
It's blue. No,
it's blue.
It's blue, yeah. Very, very light blue.
Very cool. And we've also, is it Darla that just joined us? Hello there. Can you tell us your location?
Hello, now I'm... Okay, I'm now pointing at... where is this? Northwest. And you know, I've shown you the sunrise right from here, and I got camera right now. Sunrise was from here, and the sunset will be from here. You see, there's just maybe 100 degrees turn. Of
wow,
course, in reverse
cool.
direction, that sounds travel. Uh-huh.
Can you tell us your location and your local time, please?
Okay. This is Ankara, Turkey. Ankara, Turkey, and it's, I think, 19:30, 7:30 p.m. right now. Is it? I don't know.
Just repeat your location just once more while you're on the live feed. You're currently live.
Okay. Ankara, Turkey. Ankara, Turkey. Turkey, in Turkey, capital city of Turkey, Ankara.
How long ago did it rise?
About 2 hours ago. Like 5:30 or so, it was pretty pink.
So 2 hours ago, we got sunrise in Hawaii, and what, in about 30 minutes, well, now-ish, the sun's setting in Turkey, so... Oh, excuse me. Yeah, that's excellent.
Yes. Yeah, it's great.
That is really good. Sorry to break your geocentric model. I didn't mean to.
Yeah, someone was saying something?
Yes. Was it Carrie? Were you saying something?
No, but it is pretty, it is coming up pretty high. I don't know if you can see that. It's behind the clouds a little bit.
Yes.
But a white sun this morning.
Yes. It looks like you might have had some chemtrailing. So, it came up 2 hours ago in Hawaii.
Yep.
Okay. So now I would like to know if we can hear from somebody in Western Canada or Northwestern US to see when it comes up there or when it came up there. I think about 2 hours ago, Robin was showing us the sunrise. What my measurement of time is distorted.
I'm not surprised. I bet your brain's like mush.
There's still a couple of threads connecting in there.
Just about.
Yeah.
Hamsters are working overtime. I think we had someone from California before, was it? Hey, Ashik. How are you doing, Ashik? Hey, Ashik. You there, mate? Maybe not.
Hello?
Yes, there you are. Ashik, can you hear us? You cannot hear us. He can't hear us, Gav.
Hello?
That's okay. Hey, how you doing, Ashik?
Hi, I'm good, thank you. I've just been looking at your video, live footage.
Awesome, excellent. Where are you located?
I'm in the UK, near north of England.
Great stuff. Can you turn your camera on and give us a look at the sun?
I'm just going to go outside and see if I can make this work.
Okay, buddy. We'll wait. Synthetic. Hey, Synthetic. How you doing, man?
How are you? Can you see me?
Yeah,
we can see you, mate.
Asking for someone from Western Canada.
Yeah. You're very quiet.
Sorry, I'm on my tablet. I don't know if it's working very well. Let's see.
That's okay. We can bear with it. I've turned you right up. Can you, give us a shot of the sun, mate, and your time and location, please.
Okay. See it?
Yeah, we see it.
What time did it rise?
Well, I slept through it because I was up until 3, 4. it would have rose pretty darn early, probably around 5:30, I believe, or 6.
And what time is it there now?
So now we're looking at 10:06.
Right, okay.
Hello?
Hello, Ashik.
Yeah, I'm having... Hello?
Hey, man.
I'm having a bit of a problem. I'll send you a picture in a minute.
Okay.
We don't want a picture, ideally. We want a live feed of the sun, if you can do that.
Yeah, I'll do the live video in a bit. I'm going to try. Okay?
Okay, mate. Right. Thank you very much. That's all we ask, is that people try.
Okay, thank you.
I think we've had sunset behind the clouds, but now we are having the sunset behind mountain, I think. We can see the sun, but we can see its light. So I think it's going down from the mountain right now.
I'll just switch over to your feed. Do you want to tell us your location and the time, and possibly, you know, if you know the direction of the sun, please?
Yeah, the location is the same. The time is...
The same as where, sorry?
The same is in Murmansk, Russian Federation. It is...
Right,
the okay. time is 20:30, 8:30 p.m. And I thought that would be good if I just show my son now, because Ilara is now almost on the same time zone as I am.
Yes, we
and she's having a sunset now, but we have a sun at about northwest with elevation of maybe 30 degrees, if I can estimate it correctly. That's it.
Although I do say it myself, it's looking particularly pretty from where I'm sat. I don't know who was speaking then, if you can repeat, just so I can see whose levels bounce up and down. Nope, nobody wants to pick up the mic. Maybe I'll pick up a few last comments from chat. So if you're lucky enough, ADR, the backup has become the main. I can't. It's too fast to be going. Right, who's next? Doomweaver. Oh, yes, Robert. Robert, if you want to jump back in, it'd be nice to have one of the other hosts. If you can sign in as Doomweaver, click on the link. It'd be nice for you to help me with my sign out. Real life. Yes. Thank you to everyone. John Watson. Don't forget to join Gav's after party at around 11:30. Yep, you all do that. Adam Joseph Doherty. I'm still going to watch my sunset this Sunday evening. Good for you, Adam Joseph Doherty. That's the spirit. What else we got? Love you all, Flat Earth from California. Nathan, did you see the latest Radio Times big picture of a globe? It says why the Earth is round. Now, I didn't. I don't watch TV, don't buy the Radio Times, but very interesting, normal, usual globe programming bullshit. Mr. Lee Free, 77. East Doomweaver. Yeah, hope Robert joins me so he can sign out the show. Got one last space for him if he dives in quickly. Is that you? Let's have a look. Is that you, Robert?
Yes, it is. Hello, Nathan.
Absolutely excellent, mate. Right, if you can hold the fort for a few minutes, I'm just going to do a couple of double checkings on things.
Yep, no problem.
I'm going to share a few more suns, and then I'm going to bid everyone farewell. I'm not going to do any more addressing to the people who are in here.
It stopped. We're good.
Oh, excellent. I'm going to stick it on mine because it looks the prettiest. Oh, no. The guy in Birmingham's got a really pretty sun, actually. Look at that.
Nice.
He's not going to be able to talk to us now. I've cut them all off.
Okay.
Tariq?
Tafiq, I think it's pronounced.
Tafiq. Oh, yes. I didn't have my glasses on.
He's the one sharing on the public feed now. It looks really nice.
It's gorgeous.
Okay. Avan.
And I'm going to show, let's see if we've got left in. Quick scramble through, see if we've got anything dramatic.
It's been really nice to watch this, to see all the different places all over the plain that are so beautiful.
Absolutely.
Yeah, it's been amazing.
National Geographic Flat Earth Style. Without the programming.
I'm going to announce it. That is right there, 24 hours of full sun coverage.
Woo!
Yes.
Thank you, Nathan, for thinking of the idea. I guess you and Antonio came up with it together. And for you executing it. And all the people involved
who participated. Including you,
yeah.
Patricia.
I played a little tiny role. So.
Yeah, without Robert as well, you've been absolutely sensational. Thank you so much. On that note, what I'm going to do is put on the Warwickshire sunset. Give it a few more minutes just for any naysayers that say, nah, you had gaps in between the shows, so it wasn't 24 hours. So I'll give it just a couple more minutes on my sunset.